Hey everyone, welcome to another quick edit video, this time with a foggy forest landscape, which I want to make a lot darker and add some very gloomy light, kind of like that Game of Thrones opening scene. So let's start. First off, in the camera raw editor, I'm heading to the optics tab to remove the chromatic aberration. Then the very first thing I want to do is to actually fix all those lines. You can see the trees are kind of leaning to the right side and they are a little distorted. That means I can simply go into the geometry tab to fix the vertical lines. I'm dropping the vertical slider and by looking at the grid I can fix those lines quite easily. Also, I don't think this image has a straight horizon, so I'm also going to apply some rotation. Now that looks much better. Next, I'm changing the camera profile to Adobe Standard. First off, the white balance. I want to make this image a lot colder, so I'm simply dropping the temperature to get a nice blue color cast. Next, let's make this image darker. I'm dropping the exposure. And I'm also dropping the highlights. To add some contrast, I can also drop the shadows. And of course, this will also make the image darker. And let's boost the whites slightly, which will help with the contrast again. All right. We could add some vibrance just to get some more colors in here and maybe drop the texture very, very carefully. Nice. Now let's work on the local adjustments. First off, I want to start with the gradiated filters and you can see I have one applied for the top and one for the bottom. That is because I want to make both the top and the bottom a little darker. So I'm having the brightest part of the image basically in the center where the light is shining through the trees. So let's start with the top. I don't want to just drop the exposure since that would look weird. Instead, I am dropping the whites and this way the darker areas don't get too dark and we end up with underexposed parts. Also, I want to slightly boost the blacks just so the contrast in there is a little weaker. Alright, and to make this area softer, I'm dropping the texture and I'm also dropping the clarity. So we don't really need much detail in here. Okay, let's work on the foreground. Here I can simply drop the exposure since we do have enough information here. We're not risking any underexposure. Just like that. Now to work on the center, I'm using a radial filter. And in here, I want to add some kind of glow effect. So let's start by increasing the blacks. And let's make this stronger by dropping the dehaze. To make it even softer, I'm dropping the clarity and the texture. And this looks really good. That's it for the local adjustments already. Then let's continue with the color grading. And I'm starting in the curves tab. Here I'm specifically selecting the blue channel and I'm creating a point somewhere here and drag it up a bit so we get a stronger blue color cast. Alright. Next in the color mixer I'm going to change the orange saturation by dropping it and let's boost the yellows and the green tones. Alright. Finally, for the split toning, I'm working on the shadows. Here I'm applying a cold color tone, just like that, but of course way less saturated. Okay, nice. That's about it for the raw adjustments. Let's sharpen this image real quick. Now we can finish it in Photoshop. First, I need to clean up this shot a little bit by using the spot healing brush. And then I'm simply getting rid of a few things here, like random tree branches, which are just kind of distracting. Alright, looks much better. Let's work on the bright parts of the image for a moment. So for that, I'm applying a new layer, switch blending mode to soft light, and now to specifically target those brighter areas, I'm using luminosity masks, which I'm creating using the TK panel plugin. With this plugin, if I'm clicking on this lights mask right here, you can see I'm targeting the brightest areas quite easily. And that's exactly the luminance range I want to work with. So let's apply this layer mask, then grab the brush tool. Let's reduce the opacity though, to not make this effect too strong. And let's see, I'm going to use an almost white color. And now let's paint in some more highlights. I can make the opacity stronger, I guess. That looks really, really cool. Now let's merge them. Next, I think it's already time to check the Nick Collection plugin. So let's see what we can find here. In this case, I'm going with the Glamour Glow effect to apply this gloomy light effect. Let's reduce the glow warmth a bit to make it colder. And I can adjust the shadows a bit to make it darker or brighter. I think I want to add some more contrast by making them darker. And let's see, for the highlights, I'm going to drop them a little bit. That looks pretty cool. Let's apply it like that. Now I think the blue color cast might be a little bit too much, so let's add a vibrance adjustment layer. Actually, let's add a hue and saturation adjustment layer. Select the blue tones. And let's drop the saturation. Finally, let's add some more brightness. I'm adding another new layer and again use the soft light blending mode. This time with a completely white brush though. I'm painting in some more brightness. Actually, that doesn't look good. Let's get rid of it and do it one more time. Apply a new layer. Change the blending mode to soft light, but again I'm using the TK panel to add this luminosity mask to this layer. And again, let's paint in some more glow. This looks way, way better. So at this point, I want to stop the editing. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you so much for watching this video.